Now the next we are going to learn how to write JUnit test cases using Mockito framework for our REST APIs all layer, that is controller layer, service layer and repository layer. Now we will write the JUnit test cases using Mockito framework for our all layers. So first here I will write the JUnit test cases for our service layer, that is student service implementation class. So first I will write the JUnit test cases for service layer, and here we can see we are using the student repository, but in test cases we no need to make actual code to database, so we will mock this object, that is student repository, in our service layer. And the mock means we will tell to our application when we will call this method of the service layer, means student repository layer, and it will return this result and don't go to the particular service or call the actual layer. So let's create the test classes for this. So here I will go to new and here click on others, and here I will find JUnit test case and next. So it will be the package name and it will be the student service IMPL test, and click on finish. So here we can see this is the test classes, and here I can just define at the rate Spring Boot test annotation at our test class. So here I will write the JUnit test cases for a method. So first I will remove this one that was generated by default. So here what I will do, I will write JUnit test for get student by ID API, and return type for the test cases will be void test get student by ID successfully. So here what I will do, here I will just define string student name is equal to ABC. We can define any name ABC. So here we are going to write the JUnit test case for our service layer. So first I will auto add our service class here, student service, student service. And next we know in student service if we are going to test get student by ID. So here we can see we are here making call to student repository, but now we are just writing the JUnit test case for our service layer. We are not going to test our repository layer, so we need to make it as mock in our test cases. So here what I will do, here I will just define at the rate mock bean annotation. So here I will create the mock bean for student repository. So here we are going to write the JUnit cases for get student by ID. Get student by ID. So here we will just pass the student ID, and here I am just passing 1, and it will return the object student by ID. But here we know inside our service layer we are also calling repository layer, but we don't want to make actual call. And here what I will expect, here we will expecting assert all equals, and here we are expecting expected values is the student name, and here we will get one student by ID object, and from this ID object we will get student name. If both are same, then our unit test case will be execute successfully. But we are not making actual call to repository, then we need to do some setup before making repository layer actual call. So here I will use at the rate before annotation, So this method will execute before all test cases. So here I can define the name for setup. And before each function we want to execute, then we can use @ before each annotation. So now what I will do here, I will just create the object for student entity. So here I have just created one student object, java.util.optional. So here I have just created student entity object with id 1 and name abc and roll number 100 and CT is DLH. So now I will tell to my code. So here I will call mockito.when, and here I will call copy student repository dot find by ID. When this function will be execute with ID 1, then return student. Then return this student object as a response. So now I will run this test class and will execute this JUnit test case. And here we just need to define annotation @test. So run as JUnit test case. So here we can see our test case was executed successfully. So here we can see the green line. If we will pass some different value, it will be fail because we are returning student name abc and we are expecting here student name abc1. Now if I will execute it again, now it will be fail. And now here we can see the red line because here we were expected name was abc1, but actually we are getting abc. And we can also see the database, there were no record added into database also. There were only one record, that is student with id 5. So like this we can write all JUnit test cases for service layer, but here I have just write only one JUnit test case for one method, that is get student by ID. Now I will go and write the JUnit test cases for our student repository layer. And as we know, testing the repository layer is little bit tricky here because this layer is interacting directly with database. And we don't want to store any junk data into database while we are performing our testing. So here what I will do, here first I will create one new class. So here I will go here, click on new and click on other and JUnit test case, next and finish. So here what we can do, here we can use annotation, that is @ data jpa testing data jpa test. So we can use this annotation for testing our repository layer only. So what it will do, this annotation, it will do when we will try to persist data into database, that particular data will be persist into database at the time of particular test case execution. But when this particular method is completed, the data will be flushed out. So that is the one advantage while we are using @ data jpa test. Or there is one more way, you can use different database for testing, like in memory database or containerized database also. But here what we will focus, on @ data jpa test annotation to test our repository layer. So here we will also validate how data is saving into database while executing the test case and how it will automatically delete when the test case execution is completed, the data will be automatically flushed. Here I have already created one class for JUnit test case of repository layer. Now I will remove the default method. Here I will write the test case for find by ID. So here I will just define annotation at the rate test, and here I will define public void find by ID. Find by ID. And here what we'll do, we will just import this test annotation, and here I will auto add our repository layer because we are going to test our student repository. So here I will import So now I will copy it, and here what I will do, student repository dot find by ID, and here I will just pass the ID 1, and as we know it is not present in database, and we'll call get, so it will return me student object. And here we also need to do some more setup before calling this test actual. So here I will call use same annotation that we have used in our previous JUnit test class at the rate before each, and here I will just make setup. So here I will create student object, student entity is our entity name, new student entity name 1, roll number 101, and address we can define any. So here it's showing some compile time error that in student entity. So here we can use string integer integer. So first will be the student entity we need to check, and we need to check here constructor that contains three parameter, and there is one more that contains four parameter. So we can use this one, student entity, and we'll go back to our student repository test class, and here I will just pass the four parameter. And now what we need to do, we also need to auto void our entity manager class, but here what we will choose, here we will use test entity manager, test entity manager. So it will persist the data, and while after execution complete for test case it will flush the data. So here I will use entity manager dot persist. So we will persist the same object into database, that is student entity, and once the test case execution complete, it will automatically flush the this record from database. And now I will go here, and here I will assert equal, here I will validate the object. And here I will just pass the student name that we are expecting, ABC, because here we are saving the object ABC, we can write any name, XYZ. So here I will also define XYZ, and actual what we are getting, student entity dot get name. Now our test case has completed. Now I will run JUnit test case. So here we can see our test case has been failed to execute due to some load context failed to load application context. So here we also need to define one more annotation, that is at the rate auto configure test database. So now we need to run our JUnit test case again. And here we will check it again. And here we are getting no value present. And the object was not found because here we are saving the student entity with student ID 44 and we are trying to get student with ID 1. So it will not available. So what I will do now, again execute with same ID. So here now we can see our test case was executed successfully. We will get the same name XYZ that we are expected, and we got the same name. And in database we can also check, here is only one record that we have already saved, but there is no more record in database. Now we have completed the JUnit test case for our repository layer. Like this we can add more test cases in our repository class for other methods also. Now I will go and create other JUnit test case for controller layer. So okay, now let's go and do the controller testing. So first I will go to my controller class, that is student controller. So click on new, other JUnit test case, next, and click on finish. So here one more class has generated, that is at the rate, that is student controller test. So testing for controller layer is something different, and controller layer is called when we hit our REST endpoint from Swagger UI, then our controller layer execute. To hit the REST endpoint from our test class, we will need to use mock MVC. So here I will choose the annotation, that is at the rate web MVC test. So here I will use this annotation, and here I will pass our class name, that is student controller. No need to pass test, student controller dot class, because we are going to write the JUnit test case for our student controller class. And here we need to define mock MVC, because we have to hit REST endpoint. To call REST endpoint we need to use mock MVC. So here I will use annotation at the rate auto void, and here I will define mock MVC. And we are just going to test our controller layer, we are not going to test our service layer. So when it will call, because our controller layer is dependent on service layer, because inside controller we are calling to our service layer also. So here we can see from our controller class we are calling our student service also. So we need to mock this student service also in our test class. So what I will do, I will go back to our student controller test, and here I will use annotation at the rate mock pin. So it will not test our service layer, private student service, student service. So we will make this call as a mock. When we will call service layer any method, we will return the response as we want. And here we need to do setup before making actual test case. So what I will do, here I will just define private student entity, student, and here I will define annotation at the rate before each. So we will mock all the object inside this method. So here what I will do, define the method name void setup. So this method will be execute before each test case, and here I will define student. So I will go back to our student repository test and just copy it from here and go to our controller test layer and we'll paste it here. And here what I will do, here I will mock the service layer request. So here I will call mockito.when. Here I will call student service dot save or add student. Here I am going to write JUnit test case for add student. So then it will return this student. Now I will write JUnit test case for add student. So here we no need to mock this object. Here I will just mock the same object inside our test case. So I will just paste it here, and here we need to import. So here we what we need to do, here we just need to add or throws the exception. So now our test case has been completed. So here what we can see, here I have just created student entity object with same ID, name and roll number and CT. And next what I will did, mockito.when, when we will call student service layer, we will just return the student that we have created in our before each. And here what I did, mockmvc.perform, and here I am using mockmvc request builder class, and here I am just calling post API because student API is post, and here I am passing the URL of API. Here we can check the URL also. What is the URL of our post API? /student/. So here I will go and check /student/, and content type will be application or JSON. And here it is our request body in the form of string. So ID 44, name XYZ, roll number this, and address this. So when we will make this call, we will expecting the status will be OK 200. Now I will just run this test case. Run as JUnit test. So here we can see our test case was executed successfully. Like this, we can test our all REST endpoint in our controller layer. So this all was about our JUnit test cases using Mockito framework.